you printing your rotten lies about us, Vance?
I prided myself on telling the truth, Mr. Denville. Everyone knows you have a stranglehold on the town. The settlers are up in arms about it.
Up in arms? They're just disappointed. If they could make as easy a living as they hoped off our cattle empire.
These people don't want any part of your empire, Kurt. They just want a little elbow room to grow in. The elbow room belongs to the Denbos, too. Doesn't it, Father? You should make sure your readers know that, Vance.
They do, Flat. They also know something else. Here's Denbo Town. Isolated, except for one road coming in over the mountain. All the surrounding area, 100,000 acres, belongs to you. But out here are thousands upon thousands of acres of free government range where settlers could establish their homesteads.
Oh, so that's what you're after. You want it right away across the Denbo land. Or you'll not get it now or ever.
Matt, no man has the right to stop progress.
If these Easterners don't know anything about dry farming, they'll all starve to death. But not until they've ruined the grazing.
Then this wonderful government range is to remain the private grazing land of the Denbo cattle.
That's right. And you can face this in your hat, Mr. Vance. If you don't stop slandering the Denbo name, cripple or not, I'll come down to your blasted office in person and whip you within an inch of your life.
Matt, Mr. Vance is a guest in this house.
Thank you, Mr. Denbo. Paste this in your hat. You Denbo's can probably...
Hey, sister, they got onion rings on sale at the Piggly Wiggly. Hey, sister, they got onion rings on sale at the Piggly Wiggly.